Hi students, now I am introducing new branch of mathematics called calculus, which is due to Sir Isaac Newton and Leibniz. This branch is divided into two categories, one differential calculus and other part integral calculus. Now I am going through this chapter, this branch, differential calculus. This branch mainly related to functions or limit and other things, which is quite different from other knowledge of mathematics, other branch of mathematics or arithmetic of mathematics, where the algebraic sum for addition, algebraic sum, subtraction, multiplication, division are related. But in addition to that, in this branch you will learn about the relation, which totally given in this chapter. Now let us introduce the some definitions relating to the chapter function. Some definitions are as follows: constant, variable, which is constant, the number which remains same, you know it very well. The number which remains same in any manipulation or any calculation is called constant. Suppose 5, 7, whose value, suppose 5 or 7 or minus 3, it remains same throughout the any calculation. But variable, tip. Chapter calculus mainly depends on this relation, variable. You know what is variable? Whose value changes all throughout the calculation. Suppose ax square plus bx plus c. For suppose x equal to 1, whose ax square plus bx plus c. If you say x equal to 1, it is called fx. Later on, we tell anything. Suppose it is fx. If you tell f1, it will be a plus b plus c. If x equal to 2, if you take x equal to 2, it will be 4a plus 2b plus c, and so on. This x is called variable. And y also, this is called y. After later on, we will discuss clearly. So variable whose value remain changes, we can take any value throughout the calculation. This variable, that is which variates. Now variable can be divided into two categories, one independent variable and other is dependent variable. Independent variable means whose value do not relate to any other value. Suppose the value of gold, although it is related to other things, suppose the value of gold. So ornament, what is the value of ornament? It relates to gold. So this is called, suppose x. X is called independent variable whose value do not depend on any other things. A dependent variable whose value depends on another variable. Why? So let us mark these two variables as follows: independent variable x, u, t, and so on, and dependent variables u, v, w, etc. Now let us, in modern calculus, set theory is used, mapping comes, but definition of mapping is required to know other ways. Why, what is, now we tell about something about domain and range. Suppose x and y are two non-empty sets, and f is a relation which maps x into y. So for every value of y, if there is every value of x, we get y equal to fx in the set y, then we said it is a mapping and written as y equal to fx here x takes the value of the set, any set takes any value of the set x, and y takes any value of the set y, and the set containing the values are called domain, and the other set x y is called codomain, and it is called range, where y equal to fx, the values of y, which is a subset of capital Y. So we can write also in this way, f of capital X equal to Y, it is called range. These two domain and range are very important for this chapter. We have to solve so many problems, so many mathematics relating to this definition, domain and range. Later on it will be added. Now look the two sets x and y. A, B, C, D are the members of x, which is called the domain. P, Q, R, S the members of y, which is codomain. Now see, A maps to P, that is P equal to FA, and so on. So we see PQ are, which are mapped from X. These values are called range. So the set of values for which FX equal to fx, the set of values of fx is called range. Now let us define another very important definition for this chapter for function, is interval. Which is interval? Achha, of course, in this context we like to say these variables are taken as real variables, and throughout this calculus, we will assume real variable. And there are another part, complex variable, which is not to be defined here. So, x means a real variable. What is interval? What is interval? Very important thing. Suppose A and B, two are different. A not equal to B, and let A less than B, and A, B belongs to R, real numbers. Suppose two distinct real numbers A and B, within which the set of all values between A and B are called interval. So what is interval? Suppose on the number line A and B, so all the values between A and B are called interval. So what x takes, actually what x varies between A and B and arrays all the values between A and B, and this A and B is called interval. Now we define the interval into two categories, one closed interval and other is open interval. These two definitions are very important later on in continuity, differentiation, and so on. So you must clearly know the fact of these two definitions. But know these two definitions. What is it, closed interval? If x takes all the real values between A and B, and inclusive of A and B, So what we see in the picture, on the real line, on the number line, we see J, x takes any value between A and B, inclusive of n points. When it is n points is included, it is called closed interval. In open interval, when n points are excluded, x takes every value between A and B, but A and B are excluded. It is called open interval and written as first bracket AB or as follows, or x greater than A, less than B. Or otherwise, we may also write in this way, and here we can write x greater equal to A and less equal to B. So I think closed interval and open interval are clear. Now let us consider two more definitions, one continuous variable and other is discrete variable. Whenever x takes all the real values between in an interval, it is called continuous variable. It takes all the real values. Suppose x belongs to R and x lies between A and B. So we see x takes all the values of A and B. But discrete variable, in number system, you know what is integers. If the set is I, what I? Minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, and so on. If x takes all these value, all the integral value, then it is called discrete variable. Suppose the number of books, number of family members in your family, all are discrete variable. It is, these two definitions are very much important, mainly continuous variable. Now we will go through this chapter, this continuous variable. Now let us define the very definition of function. What is function? If x and y are two variables so related that for every value of x in a domain, which is defined in a domain, there is a finite definite value of y, then y is called a function of x and mathematically written as y equal to fx. And if you see in the figure, when f applies on x, we get y, and y equal to fx. You see in this picture. So here is very much important. If x is associated with a domain, for every value of x in that domain, you can get a finite definite value of y, which is called function. And y is called a function of x and written as y equals to fx. Now see, what is the value of a function? It is very much important for throughout this calculus. Suppose fx equal to x square plus bx plus c. So f0 means a into 0 plus b into 0 plus c equals to c. What would be f1? Put x equal to 1, a plus b plus c, and so on. So the value of a function, simply you put the value of x and get the value of y. Now let us follow the classification of functions. Functions are mainly two types. One, algebraic functions, and other types such non-algebraic or transcendental transcendental functions. What are algebraic functions? Let us follow what are algebraic functions. Constant function, any constant function, suppose fx equal to c or k, it is an algebraic function. Identity function, fx equal to equals to x, it is an identity function. Polynomial function, suppose y equals to fx, y equal to fx equals to a0 x to the power n plus a1 x to the power n minus 1 plus a dot 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 plus a n minus 1 x plus a n. Suppose fx equal to a x square plus b x plus c. These are of this type, where a0, a1, an are arbitrary constant and x is real variable. This type is called polynomial function. And another type of function is called rational function, where we can write fx equal to of the form hx by gx, where gx not equal to 0, for every value of x belongs to R, gx never be 0, then this form is called rational function. Suppose fx equals to 3x square plus 5x plus 2, 3x plus 5 by x minus 2. And another type of function, irrational function. Suppose fx equals to root square root x square minus 5x plus 6. Or fx equal to 1 by root over x minus 3. Whatever you write, this of this form is called irrational function. So all these five functions, types of functions are called algebraic functions. Now see non-algebraic functions, or these are of five types, trigonometric functions. All there are six trigonometric functions: sin x, cos x, tan x, cosec x, sec x, and cot x, and their algebraic sum also, or algebraic relations are also included here. So all these types of functions are called trigonometric functions. Exponential functions, y equals to e to the power x, where e lies between 2 and 3, e greater than 2 and less than 3, or y equals to fx equals to a to the power x, where x belongs to R, real number, and a greater than 0 and a not equals to 0. All these types of functions are called exponential function. Logarithmic function, y equals to log x base e, where x greater than 0, and you know, obviously you know, throughout this chapter, throughout total calculus, x is a real number, where x greater than 0, and e lies between e greater than 2, less than 3. Y equals to a log x base a, where x greater than 0, x greater than 0, and x not equals to a. Of all these types of functions are called logarithmic function. One more function, hyperbolic function. Fx equals to e to the power x minus e to the power minus x by 2 equals to sin hx, or fx equal to cos hx equals to e to the power x plus e to the power minus x by 2. These types of functions are called hyperbolic function. And another type of function, inverse circular function. Y equals to sin x, sin inverse x, y equal to cos inverse x, or anything you like, sin inverse, any algebraic sum of these types are called inverse circular function. Actually, why it is required? If you know the types of function clearly, so you can manage for derivative or for further processing, it will be easier. So you please follow these types. And students, in my following video, you will get some features of functions which are very much important for this chapter, and you must follow this for joint entrance exam and ISI Indian Statistical Institute ISI exam and other competitive exams also. So you must follow the following chapter to know what is function and what are their properties. Thank you.